Keep going.
This is so sweet. And the whole story is, listen to this. Police in South Bend, Indiana had to escort a mother who lost her way. An officer spotted this mama and her ducklings Monday on a highway ramp. He guided the web-footed travelers off the road to a grassy patch of safety. Oh, so cute. All right, let's go traveling today here. Hope you can find your way out there. And weather-wise, hopefully you don't have any delays. The first flight doing all right this morning, as you would expect, but the weather is going to complicate things in the southeast. A little more rain possible in the Atlanta area, so that could cause a few delays there. We're going to keep an eye on Orlando, Jacksonville, Savannah, Charleston for weather delays again today. And if you're traveling to Chicago or Milwaukee or St. Louis, we've got rain coming in. Those low clouds may create a few delays. Tomorrow is a terrible travel day. We've got all this rain coming into the northeast. These low clouds, possible thunderstorms, possible severe weather, and gusty winds, just not a good combination. So get ready for delays if Thursday is your travel day in the Northeast. Yep, you are hot and you are cold depending on where you are. We are talking about a tale of two temps across the nation. The west side will reach record heat. We are taking a live look at Seattle right here. It is 72 degrees. More like we should be in the afternoon, right? But nope, we are soaring today into the 90s. And then we've got a summer cool down for the Midwest and the Great Lakes region. Detroit will feel the chill as temps tumble down over 10 degrees below average. 60 degrees out there, Detroit, and it gets lower. All because of this jet stream. Take a look at what's going on across the country. We got this big dive in the jet stream across the middle of the country. But we also have a big ridge in the jet stream across the west. Two extremes, and so underneath that, you're having some extreme weather. The extreme heat is big time here across the west, and temperatures are really notably cooler in the Midwest. Let's go to Duluth, Minnesota. After seeing a high of 74 degrees yesterday, today, you will barely make it into the 60s, despite the sunshine. Right? So it's not like it's going to be cloudy and cool. It's going to be sunny and cool, kind of like autumn. Your lows holding out in the low 40s. Yes, like jackets. Like, did you put away all your jackets yet? I hope not, because you might need them. So what's going on here? We've got, you know, that big dip in the jet stream across the Midwest. We do also have a front coming through. And as this front comes through, ahead of it, there's rain showers. Behind it, there is just a remarkable drop in temperatures as well as drop in dew point. So the air is going to be very dry. You're going to have nice, you know, cool, sort of crisp air out there as we get through the next 2 days or so. And that sweeps all the way down through the Ohio Valley, the Tennessee Valley, and eventually to parts of the east as well. Below average readings all the way down into Nashville, Birmingham, Atlanta, even in Mississippi, we're going to feel it. Kansas City, 51 degrees for a record low yesterday. And, you know, we got some even chillier times coming our way. So let's look at these numbers getting into the end of the week. This is your Friday forecast. We're going to I always have to double check this because every time I see these numbers, I think this can't possibly be right. But 49 degrees in Lexington as we jump down into your low temperatures. Atlanta going to 58 degrees. That's 8 degrees below average. Kansas City, let's take a look. Here's the numbers for you. So our average low this time of year is 68 degrees, right? You think about a balmy morning. You never need a jacket in June here in Kansas City, but not this week. Thursday morning, we're going down to 50. And there's the chance we even go lower. The last time we went lower than that in June was in 2013. So it's been like 6 years. The temperature in Oakland, California yesterday soared to a record 99 degrees. And zookeepers helped Osh, the 25-year-old male elephant, beat the heat with a shower in the pool. That looks nice and relaxing. Osh is one of four elephants at the Oakland Zoo. The forecast high today, a much cooler 80 degrees. So where is the heat now in the west? We've got, I think, the core of the heat shifting a bit farther to the north. So now we bring in more spots up here into Oregon and even Northern California dealing with record heat. We still have it, though, in the Central and Southern Valley in California. And we still have the heat warnings up Vegas, Phoenix, and down into parts of Southern California where we are in the 110s yesterday. Now, today, temperatures going 15 to 35 degrees above average up here, especially in the Northwest. When you get to this level, when you get to, you know, 35 degrees above average, you are smashing old record high temperatures. It's not about breaking them by a degree or two. It is literally about smashing them, and that's what we will find today. Look at Medford going 100. Look at Seattle going to 90. We didn't make it there yesterday, Seattle, but we definitely have the chance, the good chance of getting there today, and the record to beat is 88, so we'll do that. We'll break that record. We will smash a record in Eugene, Oregon. The old record, 89 degrees. We're going to 96. Medford will break it by a degree. And even Phoenix has the chance of breaking a record today. We're coming close. within about a degree or so. All right, Salt Lake City, let's take a look at the scorching car scale for you. Our temperatures are rising, 86 degrees. Not the hottest spot in the West, but still hot enough that within 10 minutes inside your vehicle, you are looking at temperatures at a dangerous 105 degrees, 120 degrees in just 30 minutes. Beat the heat, check the back seat. Make sure your cars are locked too, so kids can't go play in your vehicle. Because a lot of kids want to play growing up, right? They want to go play in the car, and that is one way that kids do get into trouble in hot cars. They get in, but then they can't get out. Now, today the heat is on. Once we get into your Thursday and Friday, we'll get some relief from the heat as the jet stream kind of gets squashed a little bit. But for now, it's still on for another day. So Sacramento, we've got temperatures going to 101 today. The average this time of year is 86 degrees. We're going to 101 today. We'll be back down a little bit closer to average at 91 on Thursday and Friday. Still above average, but not the extreme heat that we have been dealing with. And quick look at Seattle, 90 today. Then that's more like it by Friday. We're at 73 degrees. Still above average. The central U.S. on alert for rain and thunderstorms. Coming up, we pinpoint the areas most likely to see some bad weather today and what's ahead for tomorrow. Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Are you sick of the rain? We're going to take a live look out there courtesy of EarthCam. We have more. I'm so sorry. If this is your week at the beach, you have gotten a lot of books read, haven't you? Played a lot of board games, saw a lot of movies. Look at all this rain. It's not Myrtle Beach just yet, but it is headed in your direction.